Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. On this video, we subtract mixed numbers that have a common denominator, but negative numbers are also involved, so you must already know how to add and subtract positive and negative numbers, and also how to deal with adding and subtracting mixed numbers. In this example, we are subtracting two numbers, but we're subtracting a larger number from a smaller number. So we want to rewrite this subtraction as adding the opposite. So we begin with 2 3/8 plus a negative 4 5/8. And now we're adding two mixed numbers. But one is negative and one is positive. So I have a video where we already went over how to add with positive and negative numbers and mixed numbers with a common denominator. And you can either do this by keeping everything as mixed numbers or rewriting as improper fractions. For this example, I'm going to write both of them with improper fractions. And that's because it won't be too hard. The numbers are small enough to change to improper fractions. So they're both eights, right? That simplifies one thing. At least we have a common denominator. So we have 2 times 8, 16, plus 3 will be the new numerator here. And for this problem, we see it's negative, so we're going to put the negative sign here, and then we're just changing 4 5/8 to the improper fraction. So we do 8 times 4 is 32, plus 5 is 37. Make sure you don't think of it as 8 times negative 4. That will not work. Now I have a common denominator of 8s, so I could add the numerator. So my numerators are 19 plus negative 37. So I'm adding a positive and a negative, and I've got more negatives. So my answer is going to be negative. And then I just have to do 37 minus 19. If they're different signs, we subtract. So that'll give you 18. So that's negative 18/8. And now that can be reduced because they're both even. And you could either leave your minus sign in the numerator or you can write it out in front, dividing the top and bottom by 2. I'm going to get negative 9/4. Now, if you had written this as a mixed number, we'd have negative 2 1/4 because you would do the 9 divided by 4. Both of those are correct. So I did this by changing each of these to improper fractions and using my rules for adding positive and negative numbers. There's a lot going on in this one little problem. We first change subtraction to adding the opposite. We have to know how to change mixed numbers to improper fractions. We have to make sure we have a common denominator. We have to use our rules for adding fractions with a common denominator. We have to remember how to add positive and negative numbers. We have to remember how to reduce fractions, etc. So there's a lot of concepts when it comes down to subtracting with mixed numbers. Now, this same problem could have been done keeping everything with mixed numbers. Remember what you would do in that case? Well, you're adding a positive and a negative, and there's more negative, so you know your final answer would be negative, but then what you do is would do is subtract, right? If you're adding numbers that have different signs, you take their difference. So if I would have done that, I would have taken the 4 5/8 minus 2 3/8, and that's 2 2/8, which reduces to 2 1/4. And then because there are more negatives, you would put the negative sign in front of this. So you would have still gotten negative 2 1/4. Using that method. Either method works. Right, this looks similar, but notice I have a negative 2 3/8. So go ahead and try this problem on your own. Okay, so the first thing is I have a subtraction with when you're working with positive and negative numbers, we usually change that to adding the opposite. So I'm going to write this as negative 2 3/8 plus negative 4 5/8. And now I see I'm adding two negative numbers. So my answer will be negative. And when you're adding with the same sign, right, both positive are both negative, we just add those. So we have the 2 and 3 eighths. We're going to add the 4 and 5 eighths. You could change these to improper fractions, but in this case, I'm going to go ahead and just leave them as mixed numbers. 2 and 4 is 6. At least I have a common denominator. 3 eighths plus 5 eighths is 8 eighths. And remember what this means. This means 6 plus 8 over 8. Okay? But what's 8 over 8? 8 divided by 8 is 1. So this becomes 6 plus 1. So my answer would be negative 7. Now, you could have done this with all in improper fractions. So if I did that, once I had this negative 2 and 3 eighths and the negative 4 and 5 eighths, we could change both of those to improper fractions. You will get the same answer. They're both going to be negative. And the numerator in the first one will be 8 times 2 plus 3, so it's 19. And the numerator in the second, 8 times 4 plus 5, 37. And then if you add the numerators, you're going to get negative 56. Lastly, you're dividing a negative by a positive, so my answer is negative, and 56 divided by 8 is 7. So you would get the same answer if you wanted to change it to improper fractions. So every problem can be done either way. Keeping everything as mixed numbers, putting everything in improper fractions. But then you just have to be careful of your rules for adding positive and negative numbers, and adding with common denominators, since in this video I'm just doing ones with common denominators. Alright, here's one more subtraction problem. So put the video on pause and try this all on your own. Alright, the first thing I notice again is I am subtracting a negative. So I'm going to change that to adding the opposite. That gives me negative 3 and 7 twelfths plus 6 and 5 twelfths. Alright, now we're adding a negative and a positive. Again, we can keep our mixed numbers and do the whole problem of mixed numbers, or I could change everything to improper fractions. All right, how about we change them to improper fractions? We'll try that first. So they do have a common denominator, each of them. So with my first one, I've got a negative, right? So then I am changing 3 and 7 twelfths to an improper fraction. 12 times 3 is 36 plus 7. That's 43. So my numerator is negative 43. The next one's positive, so I just do 12 times 6 is 72 plus 5 is 77. And now I've got a common denominator, so that's great. I need to do negative 43 plus 77. Okay, I'm adding a negative and a positive, so do I have more positives or negative? 77's bigger than 43, so the answer is going to be positive, so I just do 77 minus 43. So you can do that on the side here. 77 minus 43 is 34, so my answer will be positive 34 twelfths. Now that's not reduced, because they're both even, I could see, so I could divide the top and bottom by 2 to get 17 sixths, and that's the answer. Or you could write that as a mixed number, as 2 and 5 twelfths. Whoops. Nope. Did I do that right? I don't know why I put 5 twelfths. Sorry. 17 sixths. So let's see. That's going to be 2 and 5 sixths. Sorry. Alright, now the other way is to keep everything with mixed numbers. So if we did it that way, once I got to this point, the negative 3 and 7 twelfths plus 6 and 5 twelfths, okay, somebody else might try it. This other method, say, well, I'm adding a positive and a negative. It's going to be positive, so I'm going to take their difference, right, when you're adding different signs. So I'd have to do 6 and 5 twelfths minus 3 and 7 twelfths. But then I can't do 5 minus 7, so I borrow. So remember, 6 could be written as 5 plus 1. So basically that becomes 5 plus 1 and 1 twelfth, or 5 and 17 twelfths. So I'm not showing all the steps because I'm trying to get it all on this little space here. And then I could subtract the 3 and 7 twelfths to get 2. Sorry, should be a 12. To get 2 and 10 twelfths. And the last step would be to reduce the 10 twelfths. I would still get 2 and 5 sixths. So again, more than one way to get the same answer. So I would get 2 and 5 sixths if I changed everything to improper fraction, I mean, kept everything with mixed numbers and did the borrowing, etc. Okay, so keep practicing with these. Next step would be, wow, what if you also don't have a common denominator? Then you have to also deal with that. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.